What is your philosophy on weaving in the Hall of Famers and having them around your team in Tampa, Coach?
Well, it's funny you mentioned that, because both Warren Sapp and Derek Brooks were both on our sideline last week for the Seattle game, and it was a crucial time in the fourth quarter. Our defense was out on the field, and for whatever reason, I glanced over my right shoulder, and there was Derek Brooks 10 yards away from me in a suit, and the first thing that popped into my head was, can he go in and play right now? We could have used him. And, you know, those two guys in particular, you know, have been great. They've been very supportive. You know, when they're around, they talk to the players. Warren actually traveled with the team with the sponsorship group to one of our away games earlier. Rondé Barber's another former player who's been around a lot. He's busy now doing games, but he's around a lot in the preseason and the off season. And I mean, shoot, of course, you look up in our Ring of Honor, John Lynch, another guy that has been around, was just back. Doug Williams was back last year. I mean, Tampa Bay, it's been a while, but I mean, Tampa Bay had some great teams, and, you know, Tony Dungy still lives in town. John Gruden still lives in town. And, you know, those guys have all put in good plugs for us, and, you know, we'd always want to welcome those guys when they were around, even the Buck players that weren't great. But, you know, there's tradition here, and it's our job to try to get back to it. And that Seattle win was the first time in my time in Tampa. I mean, the crowd was awesome. That was what a football town crowd. I mean, you could feel it. Our players felt it. And so we welcome having those guys as much as we can get them around.
The Rich Eisen Show, weekdays at noon Eastern on Audience.